Hey everyone, this is Ritu from Texifier. This lecture is all about web automation testing using Selenium and Python. Believe me, this lecture will be very easy to understand, and by the end of it, you will be able to do basic automation by yourself. So let's look at the content of this lecture. First, we will discuss why Python is preferred for automation testing. Next, we will understand what is Selenium and what is Selenium WebDriver, how to import Selenium WebDriver. Next, we will understand how to locate elements on a web page in Selenium. And finally, we will automate the sign up page on Google website. So let's start with the Python. Python is very easy to learn language. We can download the Python from this website, www.python.org. Why Python is preferred for testing? Because Python have many built-in testing frameworks that covers debugging and fastest workflow. Python has Selenium as inbuilt testing tool. That's why we will prefer the Python for the automation testing. Selenium is an open source tool which is used for automating the test carried out on web applications. One thing we need to remember, only testing of web application is possible through Selenium. We can neither test any desktop application nor mobile application using Selenium. We can install the Selenium by using this command pip install Selenium. Next is Selenium WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver is a web-based automation testing framework that can test various web pages initiated on different web browsers. We can import WebDriver by simply writing this command from Selenium import WebDriver. Now let's see what are the locators in Selenium. Locators are basically the addresses which identifies the web elements uniquely within the web page. These are the HTML property of the web elements, which tell the driver where to click or where to enter the text on the web elements which are under the test. There are a number of the web elements present on a web page, like buttons, text, radio buttons, checkboxes, etc. In order to identify those web elements effectively, we have different types of locators. These are some common locators like ID, name, XPath, CSS selectors, link text. These locators are basically the attribute of the web elements. Now let's get into the detail of each of these types. For that, we need to jump to the code. Here I have created a simple file, testautomation.py. This is a Python file. I have already created the script, but we will discuss the code line by line. So the very first step, we import the WebDriver by writing this command from Selenium import WebDriver. In the next line, I have imported the time module. This time module is used to just introduce the time delays between the steps. Once I have imported the WebDriver, the next step is to launch the Chrome driver. For that, I have created a new element driver equals to webdriver.chrome, and this is the path where I have stored the Chrome driver. I have saved this Chrome driver in the same folder in which we are working. Next, I use the driver.get method to get the URL for the signup page. This is the URL for the Google signup page. Till now, what I did in this code, I have imported the web driver, imported the time module, also registered the Chrome driver and get the URL. Now let's run the program and see the output. Chrome driver has launched Google Chrome. It has opened that URL. Before starting up with the sign up form, we have to locate this field, this first name field. For that, we have to right click and go to inspect. Let me change the position. Again, go to inspect. We will search for the ID attribute here. This is the ID whose value is first name. I just copied it from here and go to the code. So the next step is to locate the element and perform action on it. For that, I use driver.findElement by ID, and the value of ID is first name, and I want to send keys as John. John is the first name of the user. What I'm doing here is finding the element by ID attribute whose value is first name and sending the value to the first name as John. So I'm going to run the program. Let's check the output. Again, Chrome has launched the Google Chrome, navigated us to this Google website and entered the value as John in the first name field. So this is how we can locate element by attribute ID. Now the next locator is the name. The name locator works in the similar way as that of the ID. To locate the next element with its name locator, we need to go to inspect. And we will search for the name attribute. Here is the name and its value is last name. We will copy it from here and go to code. To locate the element with its name, we will write the code as driver.findElement by name. We need to specify the keyword name here, and its value is last name, and send keys as Watson. This will be the last name of the user. In the similar way, we will choose the other locators also. The next locator is XPath. We will select or locate the next web element by its XPath. This is the HTML property of this particular web element. To select the XPath of this element, we need to right click here, then go to copy, and from here we can copy the XPath of this element and just paste it here. We will use this command driver.findElement by XPath, and we'll paste the XPath here and send keys as John98, Watson65. This will be the username. We will have one more XPath, that is full XPath. To locate the next element, that is the password, with this full XPath, we need to again go to inspect. Right click on the properties, go to copy. From here we can copy the full XPath. And the similar way as we have specified the previous XPath, we will use the same command driver.findElement by XPath and paste the full XPath here. We can see here, this is the full path of that web element. And send keys as John@98.65. This will be the password for the username. Next is the CSS selector. CSS selector. CSS is mainly used to provide style rules for a web page. Now we will locate this field by its CSS selector. Again, right click on its property. Inspect. Copy, and from here we can copy the CSS selector and paste it in code by using the command driver.findElement by CSS selector. We need to specify these keywords, CSS selector, XPath, name, ID, and paste the CSS selector here and send keys as similar of that password as it is a confirmed password field. Till now, I have located the first name field, last name field, username, password confirm. The next step is to locate this next button. We will locate this next button by using the text written on this button. For that, we will have to specify the driver to locate the element by its XPath. We will use this command driver.find element by XPath. This is the format of the XPath. We will insert the text here by writing to / and asterisk sign. The open square bracket contains text, and what is the text here? The text written on the button is next, and will perform a click action. As it is a button, we will perform a click action on it. Now let me run the code so to see the result of the program. The website has opened, filling up all the forms. Click on the next button and we are redirected to this page. So the next locator is the link test. Through link test, we can locate any hyperlink test by the text written on its link. Suppose we want to select this element. We want to go to the help center. The text written on here is help. We just specify the text by using the command driver.find element by link test, and the text is help that is written on that link, and perform the click action over that link. We will also specify the time delay on that page. So we will have some time on that page. It's just a 3 seconds. Now I'm again running the code. After going to next page, it will click on the help and open up this new page, that is help center. So if we want to close the driver after performing all the steps, we can use this command driver.quit. This will automatically quit the opening windows of the browser. So I can proceed further with verifying the phone numbers here or by entering any detail here. Okay, so that's how it works. I hope you understand the concept of the locators and automation. If you have any query regarding this session, please let me know and put your comment in the comment section. Thank you.